So much for the insults. My guests are present and past officials of the Massachusetts Women's Political Caucus, Sheila Capone-Wilson. She's a Democrat, serves now as executive director. Ann Murphy is a Republican. She's now with O'Neill and Associates, and she's a past president. Nice to see you both again. Starting with you, Sheila, what is the objective evidence that this state is anywhere near ready to elect a woman to anything? I mean that sincerely. The history, as I said to Martha Coakley, is as bad as any state in the country.
Well, and I think that the Attorney General mentioned, too, that women haven't been doing this for a long period of time. And right now, we are seeing a resurgence of women running for office and feeding that pipeline from the municipal races, like Ayanna Pressley, who's running for Boston City Council, Ruth Balzer, who's running to be the first woman mayor of the city of Newton. And then we have women running for the more women running for the legislature. And then we're going to see those women move up.
Well, you're shaking your head up and down like you agree with this. It's as if the other 49 states didn't have the same. We're allegedly the most liberal, tolerant state in America for women ever to Congress, Ann Murphy.
I mean, that is still a struggle in Massachusetts, and it really defies logic. However, you look at Nikki Tsongas. She won in one re-election.
Well, with all due respect, I mean, no disrespect to Nikki Tsongas. Her husband happened to be a legend in the state of Massachusetts. Do you think if she was Nikki Murphy, she'd be the congressperson?
I think she was a very viable candidate on her own. She worked hard, and she won re-election.
Okay, this morning, Marjorie Egan, my radio colleague I mentioned a minute ago, essentially said it's time for women to put up or shut up, whether it's the Curry Healy situation, or, I mean, she went down a whole litany of Hillary versus Obama kind of thing. Mm-hmm. Is that what this election is about? And I know it's going to be she's not just running as a woman,
right,
but she is a woman and probably the only woman on the Democratic side, Martha Coakley.
Right. But I do think that this is about who's the best person for the job. And I think that you've seen that Martha Coakley has jumped into this race. She's not hesitating because she wants to find out who else is going to be part of the ticket. But she knows that she's the person that can best serve us down in Washington. And she knows that she wants to be that United States Senator.
You buy the notion that Martha Coakley deserves credit for saying, I'm not waiting for Joe Kennedy, I'm not waiting for anybody. I'm doing this because I want it.
I absolutely think so. She did what she said she was going to do, regardless of any candidate getting into the race. She announced she was the first one. I think it's good for her candidacy.
So should we criticize Curry Murphy Healy on the Republican side, who is, I don't know what she's doing. There's an article occasionally saying she's contemplating doing it. Where's she? This race is about to be over in about a minute.
Well, I would think that she would definitely be looking at it as the last Republican statewide office holder who would have any reason to want to be in this race.
Can I quote one of your favorite people?
Sure.
The standards are still different for women. You know who said that?
That would be me.
That would be you. This morning in the Boston Herald. How are the standards still different for women? What does that mean?
They still are. We saw this in Hillary Clinton's primary race. It's about the hair. It's about the makeup. It's about the way they dress. It's about how they laugh. Do they cackle? It's about do they have families and should they be home with their families? Even on the local level, women running for office have to answer different questions and be held to a different standard.
Do you buy that, Ann Murphy?
I agree. I have to, because I've been working in this area for quite some time with Mass Women's Political Caucus, and we see what's out there, and it is tough. It's tougher for a woman, no matter what.
And when you hear Joe Kennedy, when you read descriptions of him from Friday night at the Celebration of Life Memorial Service, the blonde tousled hair, the tie not fully pulled up, the chest bursting out of his... You do read that about the Kennedy men pretty regularly, do you not? And is that just as offensive as what you read about women?
I don't think so.
I knew you wouldn't think that. Okay, so let's move ahead to this. You said a minute ago it's the best candidate for a job. If you were convinced after this whole campaign on the Democratic side that Joe Kennedy or Marty Meehan or Steve Lynch or whomever would be a better successor to Ted Kennedy than Martha Coakley, would you vote for that
Absolutely.
Guy? You would.
Absolutely.
And would you vote for a man who you felt was not, despite the history we've talked about, who you felt, even if here was only a drop better than the best woman candidate, you'd vote for that man?
Well, sitting in the Republican seat, I would hope that there would be the best Republican woman candidate.
Well,
that would be my ideal.
I'm sure.
However, I would look at the candidate themselves and have to go by that.
As I said before, also to Martha Coakley, both Marjorie Egan, who thinks Martha Coakley is going to win this on the Democratic side, and Joan Vernocchi, who was sitting there the other night from the Globe and told me if Kennedy gets in, he's a winner, both agreed she's too cautious. One, do you buy it? And two, is that a function of the fact that we learned Barack Obama's a black candidate, can't be too angry, allegedly, women can't be too, I don't know what word, aggressive something? Is it true, and is that why it's true, if it's true?
I don't think so. I think that the Attorney General said this, that part of her position as Attorney General is to be incredibly thoughtful and incredibly measured. That's what she's supposed to do in her job. Does she have the capability to be passionate and enthusiastic and be open-minded to different solutions and say what it is that she thinks is the right thing to do? Absolutely, I agree that she does, and I think she will.
In your day job, you guys are political experts. Who's the next United States Senator from the state of Massachusetts?
Would the last name start with a K? I say if Joe Kennedy's in, I think it's really tough for anyone. I worked on a campaign against Senator Kennedy, and you can't underestimate the power of the name or the machine.
How about it?
I think he doesn't run. I think he's happy running his nonprofit. I think he's out of the limelight. I think he's able to enjoy his family and his home life, and I think he's going to pass.
And if he runs, is he the next United States Senator?
No.
Sheila, thank you. Ann, thank you.